And he put forth a parable to those which were bidden when he marked how they chose out the chief rooms, saying unto them, when thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, or the wedding feast it is, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him. And friends, this is as rich as it can be. You see, in that day they didn't have place cards. I think place cards originated by some hostess who wanted to preserve her furniture, because if you don't put the place cards around, there'll be a mad rush to get the best places at the table. And so this is an occasion where there were no place cards. And each one of these rascals that was there, he'd criticize the Lord Jesus, but every one of them made a dive for the most important place. Now, at the table in that day, there were four places that were the chief places. And there was number one, number two, number three, and number four. Number one was superior to number four. They all wanted to get to number one, but they couldn't quite make it. So there was just a mad scramble. Well, that made it rather tense when the cook came in and said, soup's on, and there was a beeline made for the table. And I hope I can diagram this for you by words today. But the table in that day was a table where you reclined. And there were three places to recline on a side. If there were just four sides, then you would be able to get at the table, you see, 12 people. And if there were more guests, then you could just put in another three and expand the table like that. It wouldn't be putting leaves in the table as we do today, but in that day they reclined. Well, a table like that, the way that they did it was that the number two seat, or the center seat, was the seat of honor. In other words, there'd be one, two, three on one side, and that'd be at the head of the table. Seat number two is the seat of honor. And then around on the other side, it would be four, five, six, and number five would be the seat of honor there. And you go on around and put down three more, and number eight would be the seat of honor. Then you go on around to the fourth side, and number 11 would be the seat of iron. Well, you could well understand that one of these old Pharisees maybe couldn't move very fast, but he got there closest to the dining room, and when it was announced, soup's on, he made a dive for it. But some of the younger Pharisees got there before he did and got number two. So he turned the corner fast and tried to get to number five, but when he got there, there was somebody there. And so he tried for number eight, and he didn't make that. And finally, he turned the corner, and he got on number 11. And that was the lowest seat, but it was a seat of honor. And he sat there breathlessly. You can imagine what a terrible thing it was when you'd see people making a run for the seats of honor. Now, our Lord said here, verse 8, when thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him. And he that bade thee and him come and say to thee, give this man place, and thou begin with shame to take the lowest room. But when thou art bidden, go and sit down in the lowest room, and when he that bade thee cometh, he may say unto thee, friend, go up higher. Then shalt thou have worship in the presence of them that sit at meat with thee. Now the Lord Jesus said this. He said, when you're invited to a dinner, don't get that seat of honor. Don't take that. Because if you do get it, why, the host may have somebody else in mind, may come to you and give you the thumb, you know, and say, up, brother, you go down there to the lowest seat. And you get up, and actually to get to the lowest, you just have to shift over one, you see, and you take the lowest place. And that would be embarrassing to you. And the man of honor would be there, and he'd take the place of honor. He said, when you're invited, don't do that. Always go to that lowest one. You try to get the lowest one, you won't have any problem getting it, because nobody else will be trying for it. Then you sit there, and then the host comes in and sees you, and he says, oh, you were to be my guest of honor. And he comes and says to you, come up higher. Now our Lord says that's the way you're to do. That's just good manners, is it not? And that's all in the world our Lord was doing at this particular time.